Now that you know how to use Julia Standard Library, you now have access to many more functions that are not included in Julia Base. But you can expand your access to even more functions by using external packages written in Julia. As of this recording, there are over 10,000 Julia packages available for you to explore. You can find a search tool to help you explore all of these different packages at the Julia Hub website. To give you an idea of how to use an external package in Julia, I'm going to show you a demonstration of how to use the Plots package, which is one of the data visualization packages available in Julia. Bear in mind, this is not meant to be a Plots tutorial, but rather a demonstration of how to use external packages in general. Before adding a new package, it's important to do some file management. I'm in VS Code, but I haven't created a new .jl file yet, nor have I launched the Julia REPL. In the Explorer panel, create a new folder for this tutorial inside of your main project directory. I'm naming my folder Tutorial 10x27, but you can name it whatever you like. Inside of the new folder, create a new .jl file. I'm naming my file external_package.jl, but you can name it whatever you like. Now launch the Julia REPL by using Alt-J, then Alt-O. And then maximize the REPL window. The pwd function will print the current working directory. In my case, my current working directory is somewhere on my desktop. You need to change your working directory to the new folder that you just created. You can change directories from the Julia REPL by calling the cd function. Enter the folder's name inside of a pair of double quotes. If you call the pwd function again, you should see that your current working directory has updated. Now that you're in the correct directory, you can enter the Package Manager, which is Julia's built-in tool to help you manage external packages. You can enter the Package Manager by hitting the closing square bracket key on your keyboard. You should see the prompt change, indicating that you are now in the Package Manager. The first thing that you need to do is to activate your current working directory by entering the word activate followed by a space, then a dot, and then hit enter. This tells the Package Manager that your project is located in this directory. Also, note that the prompt has changed. To add a new package, use the word add followed by the package name. Like in the standard library, names of external packages begin with an uppercase letter. For today's demonstration, I'm adding the Plots package. Depending on your computer and on your internet connection, the Plots package may take a few minutes to load. What's happening is that Julia is pulling a bunch of files off the internet and saving them onto your hard drive. And then, Julia is pre-compiling some of those files. After the Package Manager has finished, you can exit the Package Manager by hitting Backspace. In the Explorer panel, there will be two new files, manifest.toml and project.toml. The project.toml file contains a list of all of the external packages loaded for this project. In this case, there's only one package named Plots. The manifest.toml file contains a list of all of the dependencies that are required to use the plots package. Dependencies are mainly code and version numbers from other packages that are being reused by the plots package. This file contains over 1,000 lines, so the plots package has a lot of dependencies. I'm showing you these TAML files just for your reference. You typically won't need to use them, nor should you try to modify them manually. These files are being used by Julia in the background. Now that everything's loaded, you can access the plots package just like you access the standard library by typing in the keyword using followed by the package name. In Julia, this is a plot. This is not a graph. In Julia, the term graph refers to graph theory, which is something very different. The main function of the plots package is a function named plot. That's plot in all lowercase letters without an s at the end. The plot function is a higher order function, which accepts a function as an argument. Let's start by declaring and defining a cubic function, like something you may have seen in math class. In Julia, 2x is the same as 2 times x. To generate a plot of this function, all you need to do is enter the name of this function, which is the lowercase letter f, as the argument in the plot function. The plots panel should open up in VS Code, and you should see an image of your function. Pretty cool, right? This is what the default plot looks like. But this plot is endlessly customizable. You can customize the look of this plot by including various attributes in the form of keyword arguments in the plot function. Don't worry too much about understanding all of these attributes today. I'm showing you this code just to give you a feel for what a plotting recipe looks like when using the plots package. This is the same function, but the plot looks very different because of all of the different plotting attributes that we added in the second plot. You can flip back and forth between the two plots by using these arrows in the plots panel. By default, the plots package will generate a line plot. Another useful plot is a scatter plot, which you can generate by using the scatter function. Let's start by generating some random numbers using a normal distribution. Using a random seed is optional. To generate a scatter plot of these data points, enter the vector containing the x values and the vector containing the y values separated by a comma. Then enter some plotting attributes in the form of keyword arguments. In the plots panel, you should see 1,000 data points, clustered around the origin, or point 0,0. Pretty cool, right? You can save any of these plots to disk by using the Save button. This will save the plot as an SVG file, which is a vector graphic file format. You can open up an SVG file using any web browser. Because this is a vector graphic file, you can enlarge it to any size without losing any image quality. If you're interested in data visualization, there are several other plotting packages available in the Julia ecosystem. I have several videos on this channel on data visualization, but there are many resources available online when it comes to plotting packages in Julia. So have fun exploring! In addition to data visualization, there are Julia packages for all sorts of interesting subjects, including, but not limited to, differential equations, data analysis, machine learning, probabilistic programming, and much, much more. Some of these packages were created by the core Julia developers, but the vast majority of external packages were created by members of the Julia community, who volunteer their precious time, in the evenings and weekends, to share their knowledge with the rest of the community. So please keep that in mind when using their free software. And please try to show your appreciation for their generosity and for all of their hard work. So again, this wasn't meant to be a plots tutorial, but that's the basics of using an external package in Julia. The workflow for adding other external packages is similar to the process that you saw today. Although the detail of using the other packages will be different from package to package. In the next chapter, you'll learn how to use Pluto, which is another external package available in Julia.